Well, he is one of the best comedians in the world, also a well-known actor. But where has he been? We're talking about Sinbad.
He's considered one of the greatest comedians of his time.
If you go to dinner with a woman that's 55 years old and your little lip curl up, she know what to do. Hey, Jamal, look at me. Jamal, look at me. She'll get you to a hospital and save your life. But a girl 20, quit making faces at me.
Sinbad, the funny man slash actor.
I love women. I respect women. I have a mama.
He's experienced his share of highs and lows.
My wife and I, we're together about 6-7 years. We're married. We divorced for 10, 11 years.
But today, we find out what brought him down and why today he's still standing.
We have a very special guest today, actor and comedian Sinbad. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hey, it's my pleasure to be here.
Now, you said you're the best in the universe.
Universe. Huh? I mean, I don't know any Martians funnier than me. I mean, I'm trying to beat. I'm trying to do world domination, universal domination. I think big, like Joel Osteen.
Mm-hmm.
Why be small?
Mm-hmm.
So I want to be the best in the universe.
Well,
and I put that out there. There's some Martians out there. Take me. Take me. I'll do your comedy competition.
Well, so what brings you to this area?
I'm doing a show. I'm here at Peabody, mm-hmm. on Saturday. Peabody Opera House. It's my first time there.
It's nice.
Is it nice?
Very nice.
It's one of the older places?
Yeah.
Acoustics all crazy. I love that.
Yeah, it's nice.
You can't build places like, you can't spend no money and build stuff like that now.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
So where have you been?
I'm working every week. People say where I've been. I've been on the road every week since 1983. Never stopped doing comedy. I think when people don't see you on TV or doing movies, they think that you quit. But see, I'm a comic, so this was always, I'm always, Cosby still goes out every week.
Right.
Jay Leno goes out every week. So I'm always on the road.
Yeah.
TV changed. Reality shows came in.
Yeah. You had a reality show, though.
Yeah, but mine was a comedy.
Right.
You know, I tried to do it. They didn't pick up because they don't understand. People that produce reality shows, mm-hmm. I said, look, I'm going to give you a sitcom. It just like my life is crazy enough that it fits the format.
Mm-hmm.
And I was taking my life and showing it. You know, they would tell me, could you fight with your wife? Fight with my, so you want me to, I said, why don't I just shoot her? And they said, oh, that might be too much. I said, I'm playing.
Right.
They just want you to fight and girl, throw a drink, girl, and girlfriend, boom, throw a drink. I know you didn't, boom. Oh, my hub, bam, throw another drink. Oh, I punch you. Oh, I hate you. I'm like this, we should kill each other. If we're going to do a reality show, we should kill each other. Stay tuned next week.
Well,
did she make it?
I just watched you last night on A Different World.
Uh-huh.
So how was the reality show different from A Different World?
Different World was, I mean, those are sitcoms. That, like, you know, you get a chance to move and push stuff, as it did for black colleges. It was the first time some people ever heard of black college. I think enrollment went up like 40%.
Right.
It was crazy. It was showing, Cosby's a genius. It was
mm-hmm.
showing another side of life. Reality shows are like, remember the dude, that stupid dude used to know, that said, I'll do anything, he'll jump into like a toilet stool?
Mm-hmm.
Now he's a star.
Right.
He usually would be a guy, kind of guy to go to rehab.
Mm-hmm.
But now you get to be a star. Jackass started all that. The Jackass shows,
mm-hmm.
and they would take an alligator and bite him in the face with alligator.
Right.
I don't know if that's a talent. I'm not saying you're not an artist. I'm just saying I didn't know that was a skill.
Right.
To jump from a car that'll run you over. I didn't know that was
I don't know what that is.
Yeah.
It's a little crazy for some
yeah.
people. Now, you know, we're going to dig a little bit into your personal life. Now, you know, the tax issues.
Uh-huh. You got to pay them.
So were you not paying your taxes?
I was paying, but you know what? I was paying my taxes. I had a corporation. People don't understand.
Right.
Donald Trump went bankrupt like 3-4 times because
mm-hmm.
I tried to keep I kept my company together too long. You know what's
mm-hmm.
the hardest thing to do? Let people go and say,
yeah.
I got to regroup because a lot of it was my family, was people I work. I kept thinking, we'll get one more movie. We'll get, you know, you keep thinking we'll have one good year, we'll take care of this. So I ended up doing this. You end up paying your people. I said, okay, I'll catch up on the taxes. I'm going to pay my people. We'll get one project, I'll pay it off. Before you know it, you got fines, you have interest, you have fees. You're like, well, I'll never catch up. You realize, I'm not going to catch up. And now I still have to shut the company down. Because things change. In career, in this business, we never know when it changes. But would I've changed what I did? No, I tried something.
So how did you avoid, like, not going to jail?
Because I didn't lie about it. You go to jail because you lie and say, I don't owe. You lie because you lie about your taxes. You
right.
lie when you go on TV. Or you go to jail because you go on TV like this. Taxes are illegal. Oh, you're doing 3 years right away.
Right.
So my thing is, I owed the money. They did the research to try to find. I had nothing offshore.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't hide anything. I didn't have a Bentley in the garage. All my money went into what I do. I mean, trying to make movies, trying to find jobs.
So where are you now with the tax situation?
My name is Juan Williams. That's taking care.
That's taking care. And so, you know, a lot of people, what advice do you have for folks who are in that predicament?
You know what you got to do in this business, any business.
Right.
Some folks are just what it is. We're living time, people losing jobs. Mm-hmm. People's houses are underwater. We're living in a crazy time right now. You know what the hard thing is? Sometimes you got to let stuff go. It's hard to do with your kids. Say you got kids and you've been taking care of your kids. You bought your kid a car. They used to get the Nike shoes and you said, I can't get them. And your kids look at you. What happens? You provided. Your kids look at you like, so dad, what's wrong? So you keep doing the stuff. You know what you got to do? You got to sit down with everybody. You know what? We're going to shut this down for a while.
Right.
And some of y'all might have to get jobs, which is really real. Shouldn't nobody be crying here. This is a chance to get real. We lived in an unreal time for a while. People were buying houses with no money down. You know that's going to get you in trouble. You got to put a dollar down, at least a dollar. Can you save up a dollar?
Mm-hmm.
So when you get real, you say, let's shut it down and we'll regroup. We'll just regroup for right now, because what's more important is having a life. You don't have to have a lot of stuff. You don't have to have all this stuff. How to have a life.
All right. So if you have any questions for Sinbad, you can leave them on our website or our Facebook page, KPLR11. And we're going to read some of those questions or ask Sinbad some of those questions a little later. When we come back, Sinbad on the silver screen. Are there any projects coming up? He's going to answer those questions when we come back in about 2 minutes.